Welcome back, folks. We've got an icon of performance from the muscle car era. On the bench, we've got the 1970 Challenger RT, a Dodge Mobile from AMT in 1/25th scale. This is their postal stamp series of model kits, which means they come in a steel lunchbox style case. It is a beautiful work of art here. You can see the Challenger on the front. You can see another go orange, mango orange on the side. We've got a nice metallic green on the other side. They've got all kinds of ideas for you for your Challenger RT. It is a nice looking package. And then on the back, they decorate it exactly the same as they do their cardboard boxes. So when you're done, you have a nice metal tin to put all your spare parts in, or just collect, put on the shelf next to the model, let the model sit on it, whatever you want to do. If you like to collect that kind of stuff, it's pretty cool. I will take a look at the parts inside the box before we start building things up. First up will be the large decal sheet. If you can't see it on the camera, because they do disappear with this light colored decal background, the black stripes are imitated in white right underneath them, as well as a black, white, red and yellow tail stripe. We've got the large Dodge hood blackout. We've got a full set of gauges, top and bottom. We've got tons of license plate options. 1, 2, 3, 4 license plate options. We've got 446 pack decals. They always called those out pretty big on the Mopars. We've got RT emblems, Challenger RTs for the grill and the rear. We've got 6-pack decals for the intake or for the air cleaner, and then Dodge logos in silver. So a fully complimentary decal sheet in the box to make sure you get it built up right. We've got a set of 4 tires in the box, which surprised me giving the plethora of round 2 pad printed tires that this one has black walls on both sides. I was fully expecting some wide ovals, some Goodyear polyglasses, or even red stripes. So that was a surprise. They're nice hollow tires. They will stretch over the wheels if you assemble the wheels first. We've got a set of transparent red taillights. Makes building on the back easier. Then we've got separate glass pieces, back glass and windshield, nice and clear, and separate headlights, so they're not molded into the grill. Speaking of the grill, it is right there for you with the Challenger logos built into it. We've got 1 set of rally wheels. We've got an optional set of valve covers. We've got the 440 valve covers. We've got our side mirrors in chrome, front and rear bumpers. Of course, we'll be putting our taillights in there. And then we've got our other bumper pieces. So you can see on that one, we've got a nice chrome tree. Not huge, but definitely gets the job done for us. Switching to the other side of the table, you'll see that it does have a separate nose piece. What I like on this one is that is a nice big lip, that entire area up there to attach it to the body. Got our firewall. Actually has a wiper motor on it. So good enough detail on that. We've got the vinyl top. You can see on all the box art, it's got a hard top on it. So we've got the vinyl top as a separate piece. We've got the hood with an opening for a blower option, though I haven't seen the blower in the chrome parts. We've got our distributor. We've got our wheel backs, belt and pulley system, shocks. We've got our intake system. Very interesting. We got our spoiler here that mounts right to the deck. On this one here, we've got our front suspension and torsion bars. We've got our manifolds. We've got our 440 with transmission attached. 2 halves on that one. On the next tree, the differential and springs are one piece. We've got the other half of the differential. Drive shaft, another set of wheel backs, steering wheel. We've got cylinder heads here, fan system, battery, distributor, starter, good parts, water pump, oil filter, and fuel pump all on one part there. What else we got going on the table? We got a really nice representation of the Mopar seats. I mean, those are very nicely done. If you wanted those to put into a different kind of hot rod, maybe a tea bucket, those are going to look the very part if you don't use them in this car. You just use this car as a parts donor. We have our rear trim panel. On this one here, we've got our stock hood without any cutouts. Looks great underneath too. Even has a insulation texture to it. We've got our exhaust system, resonators and mufflers. We've got our six-pack intake right there. Got our six-pack air cleaner. Top of our dashboard, other shock absorbers, belt and pulley system with power steering, and we've got our other intake here. So we're mounting our air cleaner on it. Looks pretty cool. We've got the rest of our dashboard. Beautifully done. Those decals will work quite nicely on there. Otherwise, it's all the plastivinyl, and we saw the top that'll be glued on it. Got our radiator mount with fan shroud. In the box as well, we've got a one-piece interior tub, center console molded in, door panels. These are always very simple on these cars. Rear seats with their fake buckets there, but they're not too bad. I've been in them. Three pedals, kind of just blobs for the pedals, but they'll suffice. Paint them black, you're ready to go. We've got our chassis here. Even got parking brake lines on it going back. Can you see those? Real faint, but they're in there. You dry brush that, they'll pop out right away. Nice looking frame on there, all the way back with that unibody. And then, what blew my mind when I opened the box was, it's a convertible. So if you wanted this to be a convertible, just don't attach that vinyl top. Or you can attach the vinyl top. It says removable top on the box. Nice trim around there. We can easily get a chrome marker or a silver marker in there. All the way around. Get a good look at that body. The Challengers, the Cudas, are such great looking cars. Obviously, you'll be removing these and be careful when you move all this bracing because that windshield frame is nice and thin. So be very careful. So that is a sharp looking ride. I'm going to start gluing mine together and I will be back in just a moment. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hello there. As you can tell by the assembly process, not a very difficult kit to build so far. What we're going to look at is some parts, and then we're going to go get everything into paint, and we'll start on the details section after that. Got the belt and pulley system glued together. I just put the fan on, and then I will paint that all up. We'll attach our alternator, and we'll be fine there. Something I noticed inside the kit was the only spoiler. We went through all the parts and stuff like that. The only spoiler I could find was the one we showed in there, and I do not see any sort of spoiler that resembles these Mopar option spoilers on the back here in the kit at all. So just to let you know, when you pick this one up, I didn't find that in there at all. I double checked. If I missed it, it would be in that parts review I did in the beginning of the video, but I could not find that, so I will not have the spoiler. I have that little roll-up spoiler that we saw in the parts review, but I don't want to put that on my Challenger, so I don't want that on there. I was kind of hoping this one was in there because I just absolutely love the look of those with the stripe underneath it. I think that's a good look on those vehicles, but this one, I did not find that in there. We got the dash glued together. It does have a seam where you saw me put it together in the video, but once I run my glue in there, there really is no issue. I mean, you can't notice there's a seam anymore, and it looks very, very nice. So use a good quality glue. What I like to use is called Plastruct Bondine, right on camera. And places like Model Roundup carry that stuff, no issues at all. Excellent, excellent model glue, very strong. As you can see, it sets quite quickly. We glued our differential together. On the chassis here, everything mounts in very nicely on this one. So we've got our differential, which we'll just glue into place when we're done. We've got our front suspension, which doesn't require anything goofy, and that just locks into place too. So I will paint these items separately and then glue those on later after I put the full exhaust system in with our quad tips molded in. So we'll do a little chrome work on those. That will just drop right in. Mounts in place, holds itself in, and then we'll get our differential in. Then we can get some body color on the chassis and stuff like that. Really make it look nice when we can glue those other parts in separately. On the seats, again, they go together very, very nicely. There would normally be some sort of a join where they pulled the vinyl and stuff like that. So I'm not going to bother removing any of that. Of course, you show builders, go right ahead. Work on all of that. I also not going to be using like the hood hinges and stuff on mine either. I like to be able to remove the hood completely when I take pictures for the video. Got the air cleaner glued together. Nice six-pack air cleaner. We can spray that, and then I will just do a little bit of hand detailing around the outside with paint. Got our Mopar steering column, that accordion look on it. That's always goofy looking. I always thought back in the day it was so out of place on those cars because it looked like kind of futuristic. And so it was very interesting when I would see that. But people loved it. They had their reasons for it. And then, of course, the hood needs no work. I'm using the stock hood. I'm not doing the hood that's cut open for the blower. And then the body, I did glue the front piece on and the radiator mount and the firewall. We'll get that all painted up with the car. And then what I'll have to do is, it won't be easy to get the grill, and I've already test fit this. It's going to be very hard to get the grill in here, but I'd rather glue these pieces on now and get it all lined up than do it later and ruin my paint job. So all I'll have to do, because the grill will sit nicely back here, and we have complete access to it from the top and the bottom in between the two, is I will end up cutting here on one of the headlights. I'll just cut right next to one of the headlights. I'll slide this piece in, and from behind I will put the other headlight mount in. Don't need to cut both sides, just one. We'll be able to get the grill and the headlight mounts in, and then we'll be able to get the other one in. Then we'll be able to mount the lights and all that stuff on the front of the car. Well, it'll be a little more work, but I won't have to worry about getting that front body piece on and screwing up my paint, and the seam would be there, so I'll be glad that it's done that way. That's just how I prefer to do it. You, of course, should be building your model your way, so you won't, you know, you'll do it your way. Then the little piece here is just the booster and master cylinder for the brakes. The wheel backs, of course, glue together easily. We'll get all this stuff painted and detail painted. We got our chrome parts on here. On the 440, I did attach the valve covers. I want them to be orange with the block, so I did it that way. The manifolds I can hand paint, the exhaust I enjoy painting, the filter and the fuel pump, and I always attach the distributor with model glue because it welds them together, and I want to be able to make it look good, and I don't want it to come off easily, and I don't want to use super glue on that small part and cloud it up. So that is it. Stuff should go together pretty well. The top of the body, when I attached the top, what I did was used glue, as you saw, on the very top with the visors, glued it in with model glue. Then I glued this passenger side down because that's the side that meshed the best when this was in flat, and I let that dry. This side stuck up about 1/8 of an inch. So I super glued the passenger side back pillar and super glued underneath the visors here. Then, using model glue, I ran a bead of glue underneath the same Plastruck and pushed it down with this finger. Once I knew these two points weren't going to move ever again, I pushed it down into the model glue and then ran some super glue in that seam on the inside, because I don't have to worry about sanding it or gooping it up. I put that in there and then rubbed it in with a Q-tip, tossed the Q-tip away and let that dry. And now, even though that top wasn't sitting correctly, it sits beautifully now. Not the most perfect fit because it is a fit part and I didn't custom fit anything, but it's definitely passable. Now, of course, I will have to mask and paint that vinyl top, but that's not a big deal. I could have painted it separately if it was flat and would have sat on there and then just attached it with a couple drops of super glue. But since it was a little warped, that's my method for fixing that issue, and it'll be absolutely fine. So I'm going to get everything over into paint, get the base layers on, all that stuff, and you can join me over there.
allá en Cumbe Alto y lo Mejía en Vega Baja. ¡Que goce! ¡Hey!
Bomba, bomba, para siempre.
Bomba, bomba, está presente. Aquí lo canta mi gente.
Bomba, bomba, para siempre.
Baila, baila y goza. Mi bomba puertorriqueña.
Bomba, bomba.
Thank you.
At this point, I want to let you take a peek at things before I seal everything up in the chassis, put the interior in, all that good stuff. On the chrome tree, check out how sweet those taillights turned out. Just used the regular transparent red, did a little bit of flat white for the reverse lights, and then blackwashed the seam and blackwashed around the Dodge logo since there's no decal provided for that, and that looks really nice and ready to go on. Or you can decide if you want to use the side mirrors on the chrome tree or what you want to do at that point when you start building things up. Got the interior done. I decided not to use the dash decals that were included in the kit because I wanted to do the wood graining on the interior. So I did the wood grain on the console, on the steering wheel, and on the dashboard. I thought maybe if they had the six-pack package, they would have sprung a little bit more for the fake wood grain plastiwood on the inside. Door panels, dashboard, all look great. Everything fits well, and those seats look absolutely awesome with that cool Mopar steering wheel and the unique steering column that looks like a big spring on those that they used. So that all turns out easily. You saw me paint that up. Got the chassis ready to go. The air cleaner is just actually pressed on the motor. Got our distributor, alternator, belt and pulley system all glued in place. The interior has two little nibs that will attach to your chassis. Make sure the transmission goes over, not under. Over, because it glues into place on that cross member. Drive shaft to the differential, and then you have my, I just did a basic detail underneath and went with a green underneath. Got our dual exhaust and resonators. You saw me chrome the exhaust tips, painted the fuel tank, got our shocks in place, and then mounted up and lined up all the exhaust and put it all together. It looks wonderful. And that wheel and tire package looks pretty authentic. You saw how I did that, left the chrome trim ring chrome, and in the centers, I black washed everything, and then I brushed coated a dull coat in there. And that looks great. Those wheels look like very much like rally wheels. Of course, you could paint those and detail them that way, but quick and easy, and everyone's going to know those are Mopar rally wheels. They're going to know that right away. The body is also done. You watched me mask it off for that vinyl top. Then I did my trim work. I did the decal on the hood, blackwashed the inside of the hood, did the front trim on the hood with a Sharpie. That's ready to go. Then I did under the hood detail, got our booster, got our battery, painted the radiator, did the grill, got the headlights in place. My idea did work. You can actually see back here where I cut it and then glued everything in place. Got our marker lights, our turn signals. Our bumper will be going on in those little holes there. And then when we get around to the back, we'll be attaching our rear bumper and trim piece. I used silver marker to do the inside of the marker lights, and then Tamiya clear red and Tamiya clear orange for those markers. The metallic green looks a little weird until you get that black top on there. Then it looks awesome. Then you add the hood and it starts to really come together. And once I do the stripe down the side and all the little emblems and the six-pack logos on the hood, it's going to look pretty awesome. We got our rear trim piece that still has to go on with that rear and front bumper. We'll put the interior in, all that stuff. I will then do a coat of future floor polish on everything but that vinyl top. And that Rust-Oleum flat black really does look the part of a vinyl top on this kit, since it's molded in and stuff with the seam already. It does look quite nice on there. And I mean, if you really didn't know that that top wasn't on the car, looks pretty darn good. You could spend a lot more time, of course, blending that in and making it absolutely perfect for you show guys and even for those that insist on that, but just some basic assembly and it actually looks pretty tight. So I'm going to finish up the rest of the build. The decals, as you saw, went down quite lovely. Not anticipating any issues with the side decals or anything. I do notice that there is Charger RT logos for the rear and for the grill. Dodge logos, RT emblems, six-pack logos, but no Challenger logos for the fenders. So decide how you want to do that, paint it up the way you want, do all your work. I will do final assemblies and let you know how all that went in just a moment. Okay, peoples, For today's video, we've got the 1970 Dodge Challenger RT 440 six-pack car all ready for you. Done in my non-traditional color. I love the purples and the stuff, but I wanted to do this one metallic green. I hadn't seen too many. I don't think I've done one in metallic green, one of these classic 440 six-pack cars. So I figured, why not? And the black vinyl top, the black hood stripe, the black stripe down the side, I thought looked really awesome in that color combo. I use that Tamiya paint. We got the rally wheels. We got everything accented with either a silver Sharpie or a chrome Molotow marker. We got that nice tail panel in. I want to tell you what final assembly went like, and that was way, way, way easier than I thought. If you tilt the chassis in first and tuck the fan into the radiator shroud up in the front, the back will just snap in. You'll have to spread the body here and here. And it spreads quite easily. It's not too thick of a casting, so it spreads on the panel and the rear. It'll just pop right into place and it sits nice and level. This is the height it sits. I don't alter anything. I do them as they come. So if they sit a little high, when I've double checked everything, that's how I leave them. And this one went down absolutely beautifully. The wheels, of course, just push in on those nice large pins. I love when they have them like that. The only thing better than the large pins are the steel axles. I don't like those skinny little tiny attachment pins. I always break them. And everything else went down fine. The decal on the side laid down. The decal on the hood, you saw that one on camera go down beautifully. And she is one good looking ride. Excuse me. That black vinyl top I did in a flat black paint, and that looks every bit the part. Just look at the shimmer to it. It looks like vinyl. That's what flat black paint instead of primer kind of looks like. It's still not super glossy, it's not semi-gloss, but it's also not dead flat. It does reflect some light, and that's what gives us that cool texture, and that's what I like. So underneath the car, I did it painted up like that, and then the exhaust through there, a little bit of different shade of green to make it look like there was more primer down there or whatever. I know it's not going to be, you know, Govian correct, Mecum show car winning Mopar. I don't care about that. I just wanted it to look cool and look nice. I was a little put off by that separate top in the beginning, but look at that. It goes down, the glass fits in correctly, and it looks absolutely fine. It looks good to me. I mean, it's a nice looking ride. It's a cool car. The hood fits well, so I'm not worried about anything like that. We got our vents blacked out and everything, so it looks cool. And I just had some fun with it. What I did at the end on the Challenger emblems, since there were no decals, was I just rubbed it with my gel pen. And you get these at places like Hobby Lobby or anywhere else, just a metallic gel pen. And I rubbed it on there, and we've got the RT emblem built into the black stripe, so I didn't add any of that stuff. I think it looks pretty tight. It's a cool looking car. It is a nice metallic green, which isn't the most traditional green. Sometimes they lime green, purples, reds, blacks, yellows. I thought, let's do it a little different, let's shake it up, and I really enjoyed myself. So I was surprised at how nicely it went together. On the back panel, when I inserted the rear bumper, that fits in beautifully with those tabs. The colored panel underneath it that you see coming around, out of the box, curves around the sides. I cut those curves off and it fit in perfectly. I just snipped them off with my plastic cutters, and then I glued everything back up underneath the bumper here with these little bumperettes. Glued those in, and that's how we get it to fit in there nicely without an issue. So that's just another tip for you when you do your final assembly. I want to thank Round 2 Models for sending this over. This is not in stores yet, so I will link in the description, and those links will be to any pre-orders that are available where you can get this ready to go and build yourself a gorgeous six-pack car with the parts that are in the box, or modify it and have fun with it and do anything else you want. That's what you should always be doing when you're building your models. Thanks for watching The Workshop. I'll see all of you at the next review.